Hey, what's up everybody, my name is Trophynet and welcome back to Bioshock in our Let's Replay series, where we're gonna go a bit deeper into the game. So I'm still gathering gas canisters and you're gonna see in a minute why that is. So let's open this door, so there we go. I don't think much has changed aside from the fact that the tunnel collapsed, so the route we should normally take we can't really access anymore. So I'm actually wondering if I can take this canister with me. And there goes a big daddy. So that's a big daddy that just exploded because of the tunnel explosions.
Here's your chance to get some Adam.
Okay, so this is one of the more interesting parts of the game. Well, there's a lot of interesting parts of the game. And he gets shot by someone.
Stay away from her, or it is you who will be shot next.
And there's the German doctor.
Him hurt my little ones.
It's okay, lad. It's not a child. Not anymore, at least. Dr. Tenenbaum saw to that.
Bitte, do not hurt her. Have you no heart?
Aye, that's a pretty sermon coming from the ghoul who cooked up them creatures in the first place. Took fine little girls and turned them into that, didn't you? Listen to me, boyo. You won't survive without the Adam those things are carrying. Are you prepared to trade your life, the lives of my wife and child, for Tenenbaum's little
Here! There is another. Use this. Free them from their torment. I will make it to be worth your while. Somehow.
So now, we get the moral decision that will go on towards the end of the game. And we have to choose whether to kill the little sisters or just free them with the tonic we just got from Dr. Tenenbaum. So that's the German doctor we've been hearing throughout a few of the AccuVoxes. So if you come closer, she of course is terrified, because normally she's protected by the big daddy, but he died. So choose whether to rescue the little sister or harvest her. If you harvest her, you get maximum Adam to spend on plasmids, but she will not survive the process. If you rescue her, you get less Adam, but Tenenbaum has promised to make it worth your while. And we're actually gonna save them, because this is actually a really cool idea in the larger scope of the story, because as we said before, Dr. Steinman forwent his morals and his ethics just to allow him to experiment more, and well, the patients were at his every whim, and that didn't end up so well. So here we got the decision. Yeah, okay, we know we got the decision whether we go along with that logic, so just forgo any kind of morals or ethics just to boost our own self-gain, or not. Just keep our ethics and save this little girl. So harvest or rescue, and of course we're gonna rescue.
No, 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 no.
Just be calm, there we go. Swa! And now we only get 80 ammo instead of Adam. I'm sorry, Adam, no ammo.
The path of the righteous.
And she's also cured.
Yes. The reward will become clear in time. Be patient.
Yes, we will. So we only got 80 Adam instead of the 160 we would get.
Those things may look like wee little girls, but looks don't make it so. You need all the Adam you can get to survive.
Yes, we will, but Tenenbaum promised us to make it worth our while.
Gatherers, garden machines. Make sure you pick up a new plasmid or two. That's if the price ain't too dear, of course.
Yeah, of course, because now we can actually go to the gatherer's garden we've been seeing and spend the atom we found on more stuff. The great chain will not be constrained by the small. I think this should be the great will. The great. Well, it's probably the great chain, but hey. So there's the gatherer's garden that just powered up for some reason, because we saved our little sister. I'm wondering, can I have my... Oh yeah, my gas canister is here upside down, apparently. So let's take that with us. Again. So telekinesis is also a very cheap plasmid, especially if you just drop the item you're carrying instead of throwing it. So let's check out the corpses really quickly, because this one died as well, not carrying anything. I don't think there's anything here, so let's check out around the gatherer's garden. So more first aid kits we don't need, and that more ammo. Briefcase, more ammo as well. And there's another director's commentary, which we are just gonna select so we can get those. I think we can see in the menu that we actually have that now. Yeah, director's commentary. So there we go. And as you can see in the menus, there's another little sister in this level we need to rescue. But just let's check out the audio diary first, the Gatherer vulnerability, because this is really, really interesting.
Not only are those little girls veritable atom factories, they're nearly indestructible. They regenerate any wounded flesh with stem versions of the dead cell. But their relationship with the implanted slugs is symbiotic. If you harvest the slug, the host will die. So you see, it's not like killing, Tenenbaum said. It's more like removing a terminal patient from life support.
So Steinman pitches in with a lot of wisdom, because this is actually pretty important to the lore of this game, the lore of Rapture itself. So the little sisters are implanted with a sort of slug they found at the ocean's floor here, which generates Adam, the stuff we've been seeing that allows us to change our genetic makeup. Because the girls are implanted with the slugs, they are nearly indestructible, because the Adam causes them to regenerate any wounds any damage they receive. So that's actually really cool. And the slug is symbiotic, so if you take out the slug, which we would have done if we tried to harvest her, we would have killed her as well. Because, the quote that Tenenbaum used, because Tenenbaum wasn't always the caretaker of these little sisters, as you might have heard from Steinman here. She says that if you remove her, the slug, it's not really killing her, it's just removing a patient from life support. So let's purchase gene upgrades. We have a few new things here. There are a few really interesting ones. So you can upgrade your health and your Eve bar if you want to. These are substantial upgrades. So if you can upgrade those, you should. But since we only have 80 Adam to spare, we're not going to go into that. But we're going to go for Armored Shell, which reduces all physical damage, which is really great because bullets also fall under the category of physical damage. There we go. Useful in any hazardous situation, Armored Shell offers fantastic protection against life's bumps and bruises. Don't be a softie, use Armored Shell now. This is an annoying one. I really like Wrench Jockey. I also like Static Discharge. But since we are going to go up against something that doesn't like electricity, I'm going to go for Static Discharge before Wrench Jockey. So there we go. And then we have Eve Link. First aid kits also give you a bit of Eve. I'm going to use that as well. Get more out of your first aid kits with Eve Link. This revolutionary new gene tonic causes your body to produce Eve whenever you use first aid kits. And we have an empty slot for that because that's a physical tonic. And that's about it because now we only have 40 Adam left. But we now are a bit more resilient to physical damage. So there we go. Let's go through here. And I think we just end up at the central area again. More anti-personnel rounds. Let's open the door. Bring it with us. And drop it immediately, because I think there's a few splices in this area.
Yes? You reap.
I don't think she can hear us. She's not here. I wonder where she is. Sounds like they're downstairs, actually. Because I want to clear out this area before we're going to do the next bit. So that we don't bump into any splices. This is weird. I keep hearing them, but not seeing them. So let's take a look around. So there's one. Oh yeah, we don't have Wrench Jockey anymore, right? Kind of forgot about that completely. There's another little sister ahead. To get the Adam from her, you must first deal with the Big Daddy. And this is really interesting, so that's another... Yeah, okay. Make it stop!
I'm bleeding!
There we go. Let's refill our plasmids, because... Don't we? Yeah, we do. I'm gonna do that. And now it might actually become pretty apparent why we started gathering those gas canisters, doesn't it? Because I'm gonna try and put those in a heap in front of it. Big daddies aren't hostile at the start. They only are hostile once you start attacking or come too close to the little sister it's guarding. So as you can see, I can't even come close to the big daddy and he just stops. It's only if I come closer to the little sister that they're gonna start being... There we go. He's not immediately hostile, he just warns you that you shouldn't come too close, which is actually a really cool mechanic, I think. So here's one of the gas canisters we found. I'm gonna pull in the other ones from over here. I don't think I need to alert any of the splicers. Hopefully that doesn't explode like that. I'm starting to throw those around like they're fun bags. So that gives us one hell of an explosion if we can actually hit him with all of these. Let's see. I think there's another one here. Yeah, there we go. And the other preparation we're gonna take, because this fight is actually designed to teach you the basics of Vita Chambers. This battle is actually designed to, die. You need to die in this fight. I'm gonna try not to. I would have liked telekinesis for this one, but I don't think we have... I don't think... There is a machine that you can use... I'm gonna check the map really quickly. There is a machine you can use to move everything over, and I'm wondering if there is actually a gene bank in this area. Because there's not one on this map, but maybe on an upper floor or something. But hey, we're gonna have to make do with what we have. So, let's check. Go through our weapons. We need to equip that electric buck, because a big daddy is an armored enemy. For the pistol, I don't think we have anything for the machine gun. We'll put in the normal machine gun rounds if we need to. Now we're gonna go with the armor-piercing pistol rounds. So, I think they're good here. Or maybe, I think the big daddy went over there, right? Did they go over here? Oh, this is actually perfect. Gonna quickly check telekinesis and move everything over one by one. If I just put them here and lure the big daddy over here. You have to be really careful when you're holding one of these, because these can explode in your face. Can actually make one hell of an explosion. Oh, fuck. Yeah, okay, there we go. I fucked it up. Okay, then. So let's go with it, then. Oh, there we go. And I died. So that's what I was talking about. God damn it. That went wrong. So, Vita Chambers put you back at the last thing you... Oh, for fuck's sake. Seriously? That's metal. You can't shoot through that. You're on fire. Take it easy. God damn it. Okay, that was not so great. And I think they actually heal. No. Okay. So what we're gonna do is try and put a bit of distance between... Oh, come on! So this is where the electric bug comes in handy, because that actually stops him in his tracks. What the hell? Come on. Don't start bugging out on me now. So let's put him on fire as well. Because this thing is really fast! Yeah, and there we go again. So if he charges up, apparently dead immediately. Not too bad, not too bad. Just gonna try not to come across anymore. If I would have been able to use those gas canisters, it would have been over really quickly. But I accidentally released instead of just dropped that thing. So let's just start whacking on this thing. And now we should be dead! God damn it. Mr. Bubbles is dead! Fuck you! So that wasn't really what I wanted to do, but hey. So now we can do the same thing. We're gonna rescue the little sister again.
No.
Yes, yes! Just let go, little girl. Just let go. There we go. And we got 80 more Adam for that. You're welcome.
Thank you for helping me.
She actually looks pretty okay right now. So, now that we've done that, we got more Adam. I'm gonna quickly go back to... Oh no, right, I can't open this anymore. I think I even can't go back here. Oh no, we can. Huh. Don't really need to. And I'm not going to. I'm just gonna go along all the health stations we've hacked. And whack them broke. If that just doesn't work. No? No? Yeah, okay, there we go. So let's gather all the first aid kits a bit. Because otherwise we're done with this area, actually. This thing isn't breaking. Probably because I lost the wrench jockey and those things. Oh, look at that. Those were 3 health kits for some reason. Hello!
Where are you going, honey?
Jesus Christ, come on. No, no, I'm not gonna come here. You're just gonna die. I didn't think I missed anything else. I think we did pretty much every register. What's this? Wait, what was this? Oh, a logbox. Never mind. That's probably one of the guys that died because of the turret. So that's the medical pavilion. So there's another doctor over there. And we can actually hear a big daddy. But you can always check the menus if you want. If you're not certain if you got all the little sisters. As you can check that over here. So that's that. We're now gonna go outside of the medical pavilion. We're done with this area, and now we're gonna try and reactivate that emergency access thing.
Come through as soon as you get there. You got Ryan's eye now. You won't hear them coming, but it'll be there before you know it.
So there we go. I think we're pretty much good on items. We're right in the middle somewhere, so that's pretty good. So we saw an explosive splicer over there. Seriously? Are you gonna run away from me? What is he doing? Where the hell did he go? He just ran off.
Got it! Protecting everything!
Seriously? You're supposed to throw stuff at me. Yeah, there we go. And then that happens. And then I'm gonna whack your face. And nitro splicers, because these guys are called nitro splicers, always explode themselves if they die. So let's see. This is not actually the place we need to be. It's actually right here, probably. Yeah, there we go. Let's activate that.
Security alert deactivated.
There we go. And look at the fancy music.
I don't know how you managed it, but you did. Come through to Port Neptune now. I'm looking forward to shaking your hand.
Well, I'm looking forward to that as well, Atlas. So let's go further, and now we're at the Battlesphere station of the medical pavilion. And using this, we can head towards Neptune's bounty. So here we go. And we can actually choose which destination we go to. But we're gonna go to Neptune's bounty. And Neptune's bounty is kind of the port of Rapture. They're using that to gathering goods. So there's always also a fishery. Excuse me. There's also a fishery, and well, everything else we're gonna see that in a minute. And well, we get a nice introduction to this area with that body strung up there. Smuggler. So they don't really like smugglers in here.
Now you had the pleasure of Andrew Ryan's company. He's the one who built this place, and he's the one who ran it into the ground. Nobody knows exactly what happened. Maybe he went mad,
Maybe the power got to him. Maybe he just decided he didn't like people. Whichever way you slice it, good man died. Me family's in a submarine hidden in the foundation of Fontaine Fisheries. I'll meet you there.
Okay then. So in the basement of Fontaine Fisheries. So, well, they don't really like smugglers. And as you can see, there's actually scissors in his eye, so that kind of indicates that Steinman was here as well. Well, I'd like to think so, because they don't really say anything about that. And, well, let's see what we can find here. We need to go to the basement of Fontaine Fisheries. And look at this. This is a different kind of Big Daddy. And we're going to come across those more than we like. So here's the gene bank. This is what I was looking for. And here we can swap out gene modifiers. So I'm going to select this track and swap out the static discharge with wrench jockey again. And later on we're going to be able to buy more slots. Because as you can see we have plasmid slots and then three types of tonic slots. But these are fine for now. I might want to swap out incinerate for electrobolt. Because we're going to come across a lot more water than we did before. So let's hack the vending machine as well. There we go. Still don't need to really buy anything, I think. We might come across more electric buck soon. So that's okay. Let's see. We can run across this what kind of vault door, I think. I think it's... Oh no, look, it's the departures signboard. So there's more crates we can loot, but I don't think... Those crates do actually have an even lower drop rate. And there we have a familiar face, actually. What crawls in my garden? So this is the spider splicer from the very beginning. And what she actually... She's actually one of the more specific kind of enemies. Because she's still there, and she always leaves rose petals for some reason. And here's a dead splicer. Also probably a spider splicer looking, judging from the hooks over here. And they clearly have the ability to jump really, really high. As you can see, starting from now, we're going to have items that are actually higher up, which we can get with telekinesis. So those are more electric bucks. And now we open this one. And there's our lovely female spider splicer again. So let's hack this thing as well. There we go. I'm not going to whack it just yet, because we'll still be able to use that. And now we come into the main area. Well, one of the main areas of Neptune's Bounty, Lower Wharf. And there we have one of those new big daddies. Those are called the Rosies, and the other one we fought is called a Bouncer. And this one actually has a gun. He has a rivet gun in his right hand, which he can actually use to shoot at us. And it hurts. And I think he can also throw grenades, if I'm not mistaken. Maybe to explain that a bit further, I am actually playing this all from memory. So if I'm saying wrong things like I did in the previous episode, when I called the creator of Bioshock Kevin Levine instead of Ken Levine. So that's why that happens, because I'm not reading from any script, I'm just doing this from heart. So there's a splicer over there. I don't think he saw me already, he's just gonna attack the Big Daddy with his grenades. And this is actually really good, because they're gonna attack the Big Daddy and damage it actually for me a bit. Not that they're doing much, apparently. I'm not gonna start out by attacking it already, although I actually should. Because I can actually help out a bit in this case. So I can unload my armor-piercing bullets on it. And then go back to the electric box, because he can throw grenades. I'm gonna reload that. Then maybe try and catch. Because we have electric bucks left. Because I'm actually waiting for him to, So that's two. Wow, that was really, really on the edge. I am pretty much dead. If anybody touches me, I'm dead. So let's rescue this little thing. And that gives us a bit more Adam shebang.
You have shown kindness to my little one.
Thank you.
But are you really a friend to us? Regardless, a little one brings you a gift to demonstrate our appreciation.
And there we go. So this is the reward we get from Tannenbaum. Every three little sisters we rescue, we actually get a little reward, and it will be inside of a teddy bear at the next gatherer's garden we come across. Now, I don't want to die. Weirdly enough, I don't want to die. So let's heal at this thing. We hacked it. And then I'm gonna just whack it to bits. There we go. And that gives us a few more health kits. I don't know why that actually gives us more than one, because I think it's supposed to only give us one. So let's go back to Electrobolt, swap back to the normal pistol rounds. And then, let's see, I'm gonna go... Ooh, there's still a mine here. That is interesting. As you saw, the explosive materials we can use are actually the most interesting ones we can use damage-wise against Big Daddy, so that's why I was gathering... So there's a turret below here. So I'm gonna hack this thing as well. So I actually should have done that before the Big Daddy fight, because that would actually have been handy. But I think the Big Daddy just destroys that in one hit, so maybe not that beneficial. Let's see, more bandages. I'm not gonna be able to use that anymore since I healed. And there's something over there as well. So as you can see, the Rosie actually throws proximity mines that actually stay on the level as long as I... So there's another turret over there, but since we're that far away, it doesn't really hit us that well. For some reason, it still does. I'm gonna go around and then hack it like this. There we go, another turret for us, and an AccuVox.
Putting all the bathyspheres in lockdown until further notice. Ryan had us install some kind of genetic device into the thing, so only Ryan and his inner circle will be able to use them without dispensation. But the boys tell me, the keys are pretty unreliable. Sisters, cousins, anybody in the ballpark genetically will be able to come and go as they see fit.
So there we go, this is actually a very important little audio diary, tidbit of information. He mentioned that the bathyspheres right now are locked. They can't be used by anybody except for Andrew Ryan and his immediate inner circle. It does also mention that, pretty much anybody that has kind of a genetic link to Andrew Ryan can access it. But that kind of assumes, now we can actually assume, that we, the character we play as, Jack, is in somehow related to Andrew Ryan himself. Which kind of makes you wonder, doesn't it? Medical expert. With medical expert, your first aid kits will go farther, healing sickness and injury at a rate you're sure to find astonishing. Don't use a first aid kit without your best friend, medical expert. So I'm gonna do that, aside from the Hackers Delight. I'm gonna switch that out for that.
I'll do what you say.
And now there's another splicer that just entered the area. I don't think there's anything here. I don't think we can actually... Can we actually get that? No, we can't. So now I have two turrets firing at that splicer. Jesus Christ, woman. Jesus Christ! Suddenly, three splicers came into the mix. So these are all dead. And then the one over here probably. Also empty. And we got a bit more pistol rounds. And switch back to the shotgun, because I really like the shotty in this game. And we still have Wrench Jockey equipped, so there we go. Oh, there's another spicy over there. Yep, there she goes. Okay, there we go. So Nitro Splicer. I'm gonna miss something here, am I? So more. This guy is this kind of a maze, but this is really interesting. I'm gonna have to be careful because there might be a lot of splicers here. But on the other side, there's a gatherer's garden, and there's a little sister that just dropped off the teddy bear. So thank you. Thank you. So let's open this up. 200 Adam. So that just makes it slightly better than I anticipated. And then we have a new plasmid, the hypnotized Big Daddy plasmid. Need a bodyguard in a pinch. Our new hypnotized plasmid will fool a Big Daddy into protecting you as if you were its own little sister. I'm not gonna equip that. I'm gonna store that in the gene bank and a few more armor piercing rounds. And there's a rocket turret firing at us. Let's see. How should we approach this? I want to have that thing at our disposal. Did you hear that? So let's take out these guys. And then I am going to use a first aid kit, because this might be tricky. Or not. So there we go, and now we can hack this thing. And now we have a rocket turret firing at everything that comes across here. I'm going to quickly check this out. So this turret will start firing at the splicers for us. I'll send you blood. You will? Oh, okay, he's dead. So that's great. I'm going to... Yeah, okay, there we go. There was a splicer down there as well, so whacking the water did took care of that. I'm gonna hack this thing really quickly. There we go, and I'm gonna buy a few health kits and Eve hypos, because we have a lot of money, so we can afford that. And with that done, I'm gonna take a little break. I don't know where I can hear a splicer, but not really seeing it, so I'm gonna take a little break here at the Fontaine Fisheries. And well, thank you guys enormously for watching. If you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to god damn it, those voices coming everywhere. Don't forget to like it right here on fucking hell, seriously. Fuck you. Don't forget to like it right here on the YouTube. And if you haven't already, don't forget to give it a thought to subscribe to my channel, because I really appreciate any support you guys can give me. So thank you again enormously for watching, and I hope to see you in the next video or series. Goodbye.